Today we are going to talk about React Router. A React Router handles routing both static and dynamic, which means if you have static routes, like for example on a website you have 5 pages, home, about, contact, projects, other stuff, then these are probably static routes that you could handle them easily. It also handles dynamic routes, like for example if you have a blog post with thousands of news and an e-commerce with thousands of products, then you use React routes to create dynamic routes for each product easily. You create it one time and it will be handled for the rest of the publication, like the time of publishing the website. It could be very overwhelming at first, React, like routing and how to learn routing, but we will try to make it as simple as possible. Here we have a React app. First of all, let's create some pages to, for example, let's say we create pages folder. And here we create home.js, about.js, and contact.js. So there is a snippet or code snippet, a plugin, it's called ES7 React Redux and others. When you click it and install it, it will help you write React faster. For example, at home, instead of building the whole component, if you want just a component, write RFC and enter, and you have a default export of a component. If you want it to be exported differently and to be an arrow function, you write RAFCE, and here you have your page or your component. Let's say this is H1 home. We go to contact, the same process, contact, and H1 contact. React Router is a third-party library. It's not a built-in part of React. So if you want to use it, you have to install it from a third-party library. Now, if we look at React Router, we see many like things about React Router, documentation and stuff. We go to npm, we see how to install it and how to use it. So it's very easy to install and use React Router. What we do, we go to our terminal, new terminal, and npm I React Router DOM. Don't forget the DOM. It will install the library. Meanwhile, when it's installing the library, go to your application, parent application, which manages everything, for example either index or app. However, we said like components should have one task, so I advise against using index.js for anything else rather than like this command and showing this app. So we will install our React Router DOM in our app.js. to use React Router DOM, we need three things. These things are browser router, switch route, and we will explain the importance of all three, but don't forget to. Now many people say as router, so they just change the name of browser router to router. You can do that or you can just use it. I personally just use it like this, then switch, then route from React Router DOM. Browser router is a provider. A provider means you will have a anywhere in your app between this, you can use React Router DOM. Since we implement anything inside our app.js, so we use it like as a cover for everything. Switch, well, if we don't use switch, it's a bit difficult because first of all, the routers can sometimes be very erratic in behavior. For example, if you go to route dash something, then it will contact or something dash something, then it will show the contact, then something else as well. So we use switch. And if we have a nav bar, we usually register it here in order to be part of all pages, but now we have switch. This is just take it like as something, you use it like this. Of course we will create a nav bar, but how do we create routes? Well, routes like this as we imported it, then we give it a path. Path means according to the app's URL where to go. For example, if we give it just a slash, it means just homepage. If we give it about, it means homepage, then about is this path, like. But let's create path, then give it exact. Exact means exactly just this, like nothing else, nothing after, nothing before. Then give it a component, and here let's do the auto import. Let's do home. Okay, now home is auto imported from pages. You can do it like tags, or you can just self close it. Now this is one way of showing React Router DOM. We'll try to run our application to see if it works. If home was our home page, then it works. Another way is to use it like this. Route path, for example, we have about, exact, and instead of introducing the component here, we do this. About, okay. So we can use the component here or we can use it here, it doesn't make much of a difference. Now let's see if our router works. For example, if we go to localhost 3000, and take a look, we see we have a home. Of course it's a bit, yeah, we see we have a home. Now if we write about, we see we have about, so the router works. Now let's create the other static page, route path contacts exact component contact. And if we go back to our app, we see If instead of about you write contact, we have contact. Well, let's talk about how to create a navigation bar. Let's create a navigation component. Well, we call it navigation.js. Okay. Now, one thing that we need is link, and we import link from React Router DOM, like link from React Router DOM. Link then to means where to go. For example, we need home, like path in route, to is the same as path but for link. And we say home, then we need another link, this time to about, and we write about. We need another link to contact, this time contact. Now, how do we always show this? Like, how do we show this with every page? Well, we simply put it above the switch. So we say navigation, put it here. Now let's go back to our desktop, and we have a mistake. No, but our navigation is not shown because, yeah, now it's shown. Now if we go to about, we see about, contact, we see contact. If we get back home, we get back home. Of course, we can zoom it to make it more clear. Yeah. Now, let's talk about dynamic routes. How does it work? Well, let's say in about we have more posts. Well, we simply create a different route, another route. Route, path. And here, what is different about this? For example, we can write about and write something else, then it will be a static page about something else. But we will change it in a minute. Exact. And we will create a different component for this. But here, we say name, for example, or ID. Let's make it a name. What's different about this than any other? Well, here we have a colon, which makes this a dynamic route. It means this route could change. However, let's make a component for about children.js. And in this component, we have about children number, then, well, we say anytime this changes, like after about anything we had, show this about children. Okay. Let's try this. If our computer is not too slow, let's see. Okay. Now if you go about, it's about. But if we go like hello after about, we say about children number. However, if it's hello, if it's goodbye, if it's anything, it's just this component. So what's the importance of this? Well, let's check. So here we have a dynamic value, and if we go back here, like use about children, we can read the parameter of the about children, which means anything that comes after about, whether it's hello, goodbye, or anything else, we could take this title. How do we take it? Well, from another thing that's coming with React Router, which is called use params. Use params means anything that comes with, let's go to our desktop, it means anything that comes with the as a parameter take it. So what's our parameter here? Well, we checked our parameter in our app.js dynamic parameter as name. So let's deconstruct this name in the about children name, and let's show about children name, not number. Of course we can use ID for if we want number, but now we should have the name that we check in our application. For example, if we go back to desktop, we see goodbye is already there, but if we change it to hello, we see hello is here. Now it's still not that clear why do we need this. Well, it's a very good thing because I will explain how we use this. Let's say we have a database which shows thousands of posts which comes after about, and we come here in about children, we want to show this posts. Well, all we do later, what we do, we say const single post, for example, equals to posts which we have from the database dot find, then single post, then just show the post that name is equal to name. What does this mean? It means we have a database consisting of thousands of posts. Find one single post where the post name, now in the database or API we should have dot name or title or something, is equal to the name that we have from the parameter. Then we could use the single post and take the values from it. Of course, we will later build an app like that, but